Hi, I'm Chef Ted Smalley. I'm here in the Rada Cutlery Kitchen, and today we're going to make homemade cotton candy. Cotton candy came out in one of the very first World's Fairs in the early 1900s, and it was called fairy floss. This is actually going to be a little more rustic than like your standard cotton candy that you get at any fair or carnival. So it's a little more basic, and it's actually pretty easy to do, even though it's considered an intermediate recipe. That's only because if you don't let it come up to temperature, it doesn't set up and you just have a mess on your hands, basically. All it takes to do the hard crack sugar candy, is what it's known as, is a pan that will hold what you're cooking. Plus, you need a little extra room because you're going to be bringing it to a boil. The main thing is you have to bring it up to between 300 and 320 degrees. What we're starting out with is we're going to start with 3 cups of sugar, 1 cup of light corn syrup, and 1 cup of water. And then we're going to fire it up. I'm going to use my handy stir, move some of the sugar, water, and corn syrup. You want to be real careful when you're working with sugar this hot. You always have a large bowl of water, cold water nearby, because if this gets on your skin, it sticks and it burns, and it does not stop burning. As you can see, I've got a candy thermometer because it has to go up to 300, which is the beginning of the range. Some people say 300, some people say up to 320. I like taking mine to about 310, just kind of splitting the difference, and it's always worked for me. Today I'm using an induction range, which uses magnets to produce heat through the metal of the pan. I have done this also on gas, and you can do it on electric, so you don't really need any special equipment other than a candy thermometer and your handy stir. It always seems to take a while to get from about 225 to 275, and once you get above that, it takes off really, really fast. What I've got is I have a glass bowl over here, which has a red food coloring and a little bit of raspberry flavoring in it that you can get in your spice section or the baking aisle. And what I'm going to do is, as soon as this hits right at 310 degrees, I'm going to dump it into that bowl, stir it up, and then we are going to start making some cotton candy. Okay, we are hitting hard crack right now, which is right at 310 to 320 degrees. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the candy thermometer out. Oh yeah, we're doing real good there. And shut this down. And I'm going to pour this into the bowl with the that is the hard crack candy hitting the flavoring. The glass bowls are supposed to hold the heat better for you, a little longer. Basically, you've got about 10 minutes to work with this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it, I'm going to dip it in. I don't know if it's going to fly yet or not. I might have to let her cool down just a little bit. And this is how they make the different hairs and that type of thing when they're decorating cupcakes and doing sugar sculptures and that type of thing. Second. And if it starts setting up on you, all you got to do is throw it in the microwave for, you know, 2 minutes, and it's back to the liquid state again. And so we kind of want to stir it around with this until we can get it to it's pretty hot, so when it gets down to that state where it starts stringing off, then we'll start making some more floss. And now what I'm doing is I'm taking some of the leftover hard crack sugar, and I'm just pouring it around here and just showing you just how easy it is to make broken glass candy. It's the exact same thing as what we made the fairy floss cotton candy stuff with. After you've allowed the glass candy to set, you can do the old school way of dropping the pan and it breaks, but usually it flies everywhere, or you can just hit it. After you get done, this is what the homemade cotton candy, fairy floss, and the broken glass candy comes out looking like. Have fun with it.